Hello everyone, myself Soumya Shrippi, Assistant Professor, Department of Computer Science and Engineering. In today's session, we'll be starting with the Unix files concepts, which is of Module 2 of Unix System Programming subject. Last class, we discussed about the different types of files in Unix operating system, as well as the Unix file system, and also the different attributes of a file in Unix and POSIX operating system. Okay, so in this class, we'll study about the concept inodes in Unix system file. So this is the version of the Unix system. Specifically, we are studying about the inodes. Last class itself, we got to know inode is one of the file attributes. Okay, so inode is a unique number which uniquely identifies a file in Unix operating system. So let us see the importance of inodes in the Unix system. So inode, actually, as I said, it's a unique number which uniquely identifies a file. So kernel maintains an inode table in the Unix file system. So it will maintain your inode table. Each entry in the inode table is nothing but a record that contains the information of inode number and the corresponding file attributes. Okay, so inode table contains entries. So each entry is nothing but a record that contains inode number and then corresponding file attributes. For example, I have to search for a file with the inode number 15. In that case, the whole inode table is searched. It will be searched for the entry for the record that contains the inode number 15. Okay. And also here, very important point, that is, your Unix system kernel does not stores the file with its file name. Rather than it refers to the file using the inode number only. As I said, an inode number is a unique number, so that's why kernel will not have any file name for the corresponding file. Okay, and also we have a different types of files. We have studied about directory files in the last class also. A directory files is a collection, is a folder file which contains subdirectory files and other files. In that case, a directory file contains inode table in this format. So I have written a sample directory content here. So it is a table, inode number, okay, and the file names in that particular directory. So here we have mentioned some inode numbers 115. So it is directory 89 is a parent directory, that's why it is double dot, and then 201. Let me say one file XYZ that present in a directory, and then 346. Another file that is with a dot out. So this is all about inodes in Unix system file. And most important, one more point is, whenever a new file is created in Unix operating system, the kernel will assign inode number for that file. Okay. Next concept is application program interface to files. So as we all are aware that in Unix everything is in terms of files. So whatever we have to do with the Unix system, mainly it is concerned with the files. So that's why we require an interface to access the files. Okay, application programming interface. What do you mean by application programming interface, or in short form APIs? APIs are nothing but the built-in functions that are required to access the files in the Unix operating system here. Okay, so here APIs. So first let me consider, whenever I am trying to create a file, I can make use of the commands as well as the system calls. Okay, there are different types of files. We have already discussed in the previous session. So here, regular file, directory file, device file, FIFO file, and then symbolic link file. For each of these files, we have different commands as well as different system call in order to create these files. Okay, for regular file, we can make use of VI command. Okay, correspondingly, we can make use of open or create system call. So make a note here, I am making use of create system call. The spelling is C-R-E-A-T, it will not end with E. Okay, and then for directory file, we can create a directory file by making use of the command mkdir, and the corresponding system call is mkdir or mknode, both can be used. And for FIFO file, the command mkfifo is used. Mkfifo or mknode system call is used. And in order to create device file, mknode command is used, and mknode system call will be used. And for symbolic link file, We have already discussed this example in the previous session. So we have used the command ln with option s. So that's why ln-s, and the corresponding system call is symlink. So this system call, it creates a symbolic link file. So these are all the system calls or nothing but the APIs that are required to create files. Okay. So whenever an application has to access a file, first it has to open the file. Okay. So for that, we'll use one more API or one more system call, that is open system call. So as I said, any applications, in order to access a file, first it has to open the file by using open system call. So this is the open system call. Okay. So this system call returns an integer that is nothing but the file descriptor. So what is a file descriptor? The return value of open system call, whenever a file is tried to open, so that integer value is nothing but the file descriptor. So using that file descriptor, we can access the complete file. Okay. So once we have opened the file, then we can perform the operations by using read and write system calls. Read and write system calls. Okay. And then we can increase the count of hard links. If you remember, in the previous session, I have told you about hard link count is one of the file attributes. We can increment the hard link count by using link system call, and similarly we can decrement the hard link count by using unlink system call. So there are two system calls or two APIs, link and unlink. Okay, one more point to add here. I said open system call or open API is used to open a file in the Unix system and it returns a file descriptor. Actually, there is a limit, like maximum at most, how many files can be opened at a time in the Unix system. So that limit can be identified by a constant, that is open max. Open max. So this constant is defined under limits.h header file. This is defined under limits.h header file. Okay. So along with this, we have two more system calls, that is stat and fstat system call. So I will write here stat and fstat. These two system calls or these two APIs are used to retrieve the file attributes, are used to fetch the information about the file, that is the file attributes. This stat and fstat returns the file attributes information, and the return type is a data type which is of type struct stat. Okay, so I will be writing that now. So as I said, the stat and fstat system calls are used to retrieve the file attributes information of a particular file, right? So that information will be of data type struct stat, which is defined under sysbar stat.h. Sysbar stat.h. Okay. So the information that is retrieved will be of this type, struct stat type. So let us see the members of this structure. The first one, st_dev. So this returns the device number, and then inode number of the file, and then the file type and the access permission of the file, and this one, the total number of hard link counts information, and I have written here. So this user ID, group ID details, and this one, it returns the major device number and the minor device number. This member gives the size of the file in terms of bytes. This variable, it provides the information of last accessed time, and this variable provides the information of last modified time, and this one, last changed time. So since it is a structure data type, so I am ending with semicolon here. So this is about the different APIs or application program interface that are used for manipulation of files in the Unix operating system. Now let's move on to the next concept, that is Unix kernel support for files. In Unix system, the version 5, the kernel will have a file system table, so which contains the entries of all files that are opened in the system as of now or at the time. Okay, it contains a file system table. So first it contains a file system table. So this table contains the entries of all opened files. Okay, along with this, the kernel will contain one more table, that is inode table. So inode table I have already discussed, which contains the inode number and the corresponding file attributes information. Okay, so both are present, both are supported by the kernel. In addition to this, whenever a command is executed in Unix operating system, which in turn creates a process, okay, then the process will have its own space that contains the file descriptor table. So the process contains the file descriptor table. So this table contains the entries of all the file descriptors of the opened files. Okay, it has got maximum limit that I have already explained you. So that maximum limit is represented by the constant open underscore max. Okay, so totally there are three tables maintained here. So very first, file system table and the inode table. So kernel will have a file system table that contains the list of, it's a table of all the files that are opened at a time. And then inode table, which contains the inode number of file and the corresponding attributes information. And another thing is the process. So a process will be created whenever a Unix command is executed. So the process will have a file descriptor table in its own space. So file descriptor table is nothing but the table that contains the file descriptors of all the opened files. So these two are related to kernel space, and this is with respect to process space. Whenever a process tries to open a file in the operating system, in the Unix operating system, actually what happens? Whenever the process will try to open a file, there will be two steps, okay? Very first step, so whenever the process try to open a file, two steps are involved. In the very first step, the process will look for unused entry in the file descriptor table. Okay, if such an entry is found, then the corresponding index is returned to the file. Okay, so very first step, the process will search for an unused entry in the file descriptor table. So first it will search for, process will search for unused entry in the file descriptor table. If the entry is found, then correspondingly that file index will be returned as the file descriptor for that file. Okay, step 2 involves kernel will look for an unused entry in the file system table. Okay, the kernel will look for unused entry in the file system table. If such an entry is found, then that index is mapped to the file descriptor table entry. Okay, I will repeat once again. In the step 2, what happens is the kernel will look for unused entry in the file system table. If such an entry is found, that entry is mapped to the corresponding file descriptor entry in the file descriptor table. So kernel will look for an unused entry in the file system table. So majorly these two steps are involved whenever a process is trying to open a file. This diagram shows the data structure for file manipulation in the Unix operating system. Okay. So as I said, it contains three types of files: file system table, inode table, and the file descriptor table. So file system table, it is also called as file table here. So this is the file table, okay, and then inode table and the file descriptor table. So as I explained you earlier, these two will be in kernel space, and then file descriptor table will be in process space. Okay, so this is the data structure for file manipulation in the Unix operating system. So whenever a process tries to open a file, then some of the events will occur. I told you about two steps, right? So in addition to that, actually few events will occur. Very first, so file descriptor table, an entry will be mapped to the file table entry. Okay, so as I said, very first step, the process will look for an unused entry in the file descriptor table, right? So after that, it will look for an unused entry in the file table. So that's why the very first step, so the file descriptor table will map an entry to the file table. So that is the first step, will map an entry to the file table. Second step or second event, the file table will look for inode table, and it will be mapped for an entry in the inode table. Again, mapping an entry in the inode table. So along with this, we have current file pointer. So this file pointer, current file pointer, is nothing but an offset from the beginning of the file to the next read or write operation of the file. Okay, so that is the file pointer, it's an offset. So it will be from the beginning of the file to the position from which read or write operation has to be done. So that is nothing but the current file pointer. So along with this, we have different modes of opening a file. So a file can be opened for different operations. Either it can be for read operation or write operation, or it can be both, read write operation. So those modes will be represented here by using R, R, W, W, like that. So here R represents, this is opened for read mode, and the file is opened for read write mode, and then this W represents the file is opened for write mode. Okay, so the different modes of access, whether it is for read write or read write, like that. Okay, along with this, we have one more variable, that is RC, that is nothing but reference count. Okay, I will continue here. Reference count. So initially it will be 0, so RC value will be 1 if a file is mapped here. If an entry is mapped here, the reference count value will be 1. Okay, so reference count value can be incremented if two or more entries of the files are pointing to the same entry in that table. So if you observe here, for example here, RC value equals 2. That means the two entries in the file table are getting mapped to the same entry of the inode table. Okay, so that's why we can increment the RC value also, that is reference count value also. We can increment the reference count value by making two or more processors opening the same file. So that can be done by using the system calls like fork, duplicate, or duplicate 2. So these are all the system calls, okay, that will replicate the existing process. So thereby we can open the same file once again by the same process, I mean once again by the other process, and thereby we can increment the RC value like this. So reference count value will be incremented by 2. So this is all about the open system call. If anything happens, if any failure happens, then open system call will return minus 1. If everything goes successful, then open system call will return an integer, that is nothing but the file descriptor for a file. Okay. So now let us see what happens whenever a file is trying to get closed by using the close system call. Okay. Some event will occur whenever a process tries to close a file by using the close system call. So by using the closed system call. Let us see what happens. Very first step, the file descriptor table, in the file descriptor table, the corresponding file entry will be made as unused, okay? In the file descriptor table, the entry is made as unused, okay? So second step, since that entry is made as unused, corresponding entry, that is RC count value in the file system, has to be decremented. So RC in the file table has to be decremented. Okay, similarly, the file table entry has to be made unused. Okay, so file table entry has to be made unused. And then the reference count value in the inode table has to be decremented. So reference count value of inode table has to be decremented. And finally, the inode table entry has to be made unused. So these are all the steps, or these are all the events that will happen whenever a process calls close function or close system call on a file. Okay, very first, what happens? The file table, file descriptor table entry has to be made unused, and the corresponding reference count has to be decremented in the file table. Next step is, file table entry is made as unused and corresponding RC value in the inode table has to be decremented. And at last, that corresponding entry in the inode table has to be made as unused, okay? So this is all about the kernel support for files in the Unix system. Now let's move on to the next concept. Next concept is relationship between C stream pointer and file descriptor. Actually, we have already studied in C programming about the stream pointer. That means whenever we are trying to open a file in C programming, we'll get a pointer to that file. So that is nothing but the stream pointer. We call it as C stream pointer. Okay. So let us see the relationship or the difference between the stream pointer and then file descriptor. Actually, the very first difference or the very first relationship between these two is the stream pointer, as I said, it's a pointer to a file in C programming. So this is a small code snippet for that. So this is a file pointer. So whenever a file is tried to open, so it returns a file pointer. So it's a pointer actually. So that's why it is star. It's a pointer. When in case of file descriptor is an integer. So whenever a file is tried to open by using open system call, this open system call returns an integer. So that is nothing but the file descriptor. Okay. So understand the difference here. Stream pointer, it's a pointer to a file, where in this case, it's an integer value to that file that will be returned when open system call is invoked. Okay. So second difference is, this stream pointer, it is mainly used for extensive read and write operations on the file. It is mainly used for, I'm using the term extensive read and write operation. So if it is made for extensive read and write operation on the file, then we should go for the stream pointer. Where in case of file descriptor, so the major concern is here, it is mainly used for frequent random access of the file. So if we are making frequent random access of a file, then we have to make use of this file descriptor. Okay. And next difference is, these stream pointers are supported in normal operating systems like DOS, Unix, okay, whereas file descriptor concept is supported only in Unix and POSIX compliant system. Okay, so it is supported only in Unix and POSIX. So these are the differences between the stream pointer and the file descriptor. A file system that is a file descriptor that is associated with a stream pointer can be extracted by using the function called file number. Okay, so that means from the stream pointer we can extract the file descriptor value by using this function. So this function is defined under stdio.h header file. Okay, so the function format is like this. It returns an integer because I am extracting the file descriptor, right? File descriptor is nothing but an integer value, so that's why the return type should be int, and this is the name of the file, I mean function, file number. And from this corresponding stream pointer we can extract the file descriptor. Similarly, we can convert a file descriptor into a stream pointer by using the function fdopen. Okay, so stream pointer is a pointer, right? So that's why the return type should be file star, and this is the name of the function, that is fdopen. So using this, for this corresponding file descriptor and based on the mode, I can extract the stream pointer for that particular file. So these two are the built-in functions. So first one is, from stream pointer we can extract the file descriptor. The second one is, from the file descriptor we can convert it into stream pointer. Okay, this table contains a list of C library functions and the corresponding Unix system call. So generally we all are aware of these functions that are used in C programming. So first one, fopen, it is used to open a file in C programming. In Unix system, open system call is used. Okay, and fread, fgetc, fscanf, fgets are used in C language in order to perform read operation of the file. So here in case of Unix operating system, it is read system call. Similarly, for fwrite, fprintf, fputc, fputs, we have correspondingly write system call. And for fseek function and then fprintf, fputs, we have lseek system call supported by Unix operating system. And then fclose, in order to close a file in case of C programming. But in case of Unix system, we have close system call. So this table provides the information of the different functions that are used to manipulate files in C programming, as well as the different system calls that are used in Unix operating system for the manipulation of files. So directory files, we have already studied in the different types of files. Okay, this concept is already covered in the previous session. Anyways, the directory files are, there are some additional information about the directory files. So very first point says that it is record oriented file. So what do you mean by record oriented file? Actually, the directory file contains the information in terms of record. So what exactly a record? Each record contains the information about the file. So it provides the information of the file, and then the data type of each of these record will be either struct direct or struct direct. Okay, so this is supported by BSD Unix, and this is supported by POSIX version. Okay, so the data type of the record of the directory file will be struct direct or struct direct, depending on the different flavor of the Unix. Okay, mainly it is concerned with the two fields. One is file name and another one is inode number. If you remember, when I was explaining the inode number concept in today's session, I told you, I explained you the sample directory content, right? So it was containing the inode number and correspondingly the file name. So it is mainly concerned with two fields. The record is concerned with two fields. One is the file name and another one is the inode number. There are some directory functions that are used in Unix operating system to perform some of the action. Let us see what are those directory functions. First one, open dir, read dir, rewind dir, And the last one, close dir, okay? So here the first one, open dir, this function, this directory function, it will tries to open the directory file. So as the name itself says, second one, read dir, this function is used to read the record of this directory file. As I already told you, this directory file is record oriented. That's why read dir function, it will try to read the records from the directory files. And then rewind dir, that means the pointer will be placed to the beginning of the file in the records, okay? And last one, close dir. So this causes the directory file to close, okay? So these are all the directory functions. So overall, in today's class, we got to know about the inodes that is supported in Unix System 5, and then application programming interfaces to the files, and then Unix kernel support for files, and next the relationship between C stream pointers and then file descriptor, and last we studied about, we got to know about directory files, okay? So inodes, very specifically, it's a unique number that uniquely identifies a file in the Unix system, okay? So in Unix system, each of the file will be represented by, which is uniquely identified by the inode number. That's why the kernel will have a inode table, so which contains the entry, the corresponding inode number, and the corresponding file attributes information. So then application program interfaces of files. So for different file manipulation operations, we require the application programming interface or APIs or system calls that is supported by the Unix system. So we discussed few system calls in brief. So first is open system call, and then read and write operation. For read and write operation, we discussed about read and write system call. And after that, the hard link count can be incremented and decremented by using link and unlink system call. So after that, next, in order to retrieve the file attributes information, we have used stat and fstat. In that, particularly the data type of the file attributes information is defined by using struct stat data type, which is defined under sys/state.h header file, okay? Then we discussed about the important concept, that is Unix kernel support for files. So I told you that a Unix system, it maintains a file system table and also the inode table. And next, whenever a command is executed, a process will be created. So process in its space, it maintains a file descriptor table. So then we got to know, whenever a process tries to open a file by using open system call, what are all the events will happen. And we discussed about the data structure of the that is used for file manipulation. We got to know about few concepts like in what mode the file has to be opened or accessed, whether it's in read mode, write mode, or read-write mode, like that. And also we got to know about the reference count, that is RC value, okay? So if we want to increase the RC value, means then that can be done by calling the system call like fork, duplicate, and duplicate two, okay? Then we discussed about the stream pointer and the file descriptor. So in C program, we have studied about stream pointer. Actually, it's a pointer to a file, wherein file descriptor is a integer value that is returned when an open system is called. So we got to know about the relationship, the differences between the stream pointer and the file descriptor. And then we can extract a file descriptor from a stream pointer. Same way, we can convert a file descriptor into stream pointer using two built-in functions. So we studied about that also. And next, we took up the concept of directory files. So directory files are record-oriented files. Everything will be in terms of records. So record each of is of data type struct direct or struct direct, depending on the flavor of the Unix. And then we discuss some of the functions with respect to directory file, that is open dir, read dir, rewind dir, and then close dir. Most importantly, in the directory file, each of the record contains two fields, that is the inode number and the corresponding file name. Okay, so that's all for today's session. Thank you.